What is the mechanism of breech delivery?
The breech delivery is concerned with three births: breech, shoulders, and after coming head. I will describe the mechanism in left sacroanterior position. Mechanism of breech. The diameter of engagement is bitrochanteric diameter, which is 10 cm. Buttocks are engaged in left oblique diameter of the pelvis, and as they descend, anterior buttock rotates and comes to lie under the pubic arch. Posterior buttock delivers first, then anterior buttock, followed by the trunk by lateral flexion. Mechanism of shoulders. The diameter of engagement is bisacromial diameter, which is 12 cm. Shoulders are engaged in left oblique diameter of pelvis, anterior shoulder rotates forward, posterior shoulder delivers by lateral flexion, and then the anterior shoulder. Mechanism of head. The diameter of engagement is suboccipitobrachmatic or suboccipitofrontal. The head will engage in right oblique diameter of pelvis. It rotates through 1/8 circle till occiput lies under the pubic arch. Head is delivered by flexion, first chin, then forehead, brachma, and lastly occiput.
On pervaginal examination, how do you differentiate between face and breech presentation?
In face presentation, the opening of mouth and malar prominences can be confused with anal opening and ischial tuberosities of breech. However, in face presentation, alveolar margin can be felt in the mouth and two malar eminences and mouth make a triangle, while ischial tuberosities and anus are in a straight line. Also, if a finger can be passed into the anus, it will carry meconium.
How will you carry out an assisted breech delivery?
Patient is given lithotomy position, bladder is emptied. After painting and draping, episiotomy is given under local anesthesia at the time of climbing of breech. The delivery of buttocks may be assisted by hooking finger in the groin. After delivery of buttocks and body up to umbilicus, loop of cord is gently pulled out.
Why?
To avoid stretching, and if because of short cord or cord around neck, baby is not delivering, we can cut and clamp the cord to hasten the delivery of the baby. Then once scapulae are visible, baby's body is rotated along with steady traction so as to deliver anterior shoulder below subpubic angle, followed by posterior shoulder. Then for the delivery of the after coming head of breech, one should take 5 to 10 minutes.
Why?
Because if head is delivered too quickly, there are chances of intracranial hemorrhage due to sudden compression and decompression. And if more than 10 minutes are required, fetus dies due to asphyxia.
How will you deliver the after coming head?
By bone marshal technique or Morrisseau's Merriwick manual or forceps application.
What is bone marshal technique?
It is for the delivery of the after coming head in breech. Its principle is the force of gravity and weight of the baby's body act as a traction. Patient is at the edge of the table in lithotomy position. When shoulders are delivered, baby is allowed to hang down by its own weight till the nape of the neck is seen. Nape of the neck is the suboccipital point. Hanging of the baby gives traction and maintains flexion of the head. Then baby is held by its feet and baby's body is rotated through an arc over the mother's abdomen so that the face, vertex and occiput delivers successively by flexion. Left hand is used to prevent emergence of head too quickly.
What is Morrisseau's Merriwick manual?
It is another manual for after coming head of the breech. It is the classical manual of jaw shoulder traction. Index finger of left hand is put into the mouth of the baby to maintain flexion, and index and middle finger of right hand are hooking the baby's shoulder. Fetus is first pulled downwards, then horizontally till the nape of the neck is visible, and then rotated towards mother's abdomen. Suprapubic pressure has to be given simultaneously by an assistant.
What are Piper's forceps?
These are specially designed forceps for the after coming head in breech. The shank is curved and at a higher level than blades, and the handle is depressed.
How are they applied?
An assistant holds the baby's body in a towel and forceps are applied to the head below the baby's body.
Which is the best method of delivery of the after coming head?
Forceps delivery.
Why?
because to maintain flexion and to give traction, the force of forceps is acting directly on the fetal hair and not on the fetal spine as in other manures, so the spine is not injured. Also, head is protected by forceps blades.
What is abnormal breech labor?
The breech arrested at brim, extended legs, extended arms, nuchal arms are examples of abnormal breech labors.
How do you carry out delivery of the buttocks?
Contracted pelvis and uterine inertia are ruled out and buttocks are extracted by groin traction either by fingers or hooks combined with episiotomy. Anterior buttock is always delivered first because if posterior buttock is delivered first, then the anterior buttock will get arrested over the symphysis pubis.
If the legs are extended, then what will you do?
Under general anesthesia, I will introduce the hand in the uterine cavity on ventral aspect of the fetus. I will identify and grasp the foot and bring it down in such a direction that thighs are adducted. But if knees are extended, it will not be possible to reach the footling and hence I will do Pinard's manoeuvre.
What is Pinard's manoeuvre?
When legs are extended, hand is passed along the ventral aspect of the fetus and laid along the thigh with fingertips on popliteal fossa. Pressure is given on popliteal fossa so that leg will flex, then foot is grasped and is brought down.
How do you bring down the arms?
By Lausitz manoeuvre.
What is Lausitz manoeuvre?
It is based on the principle that due to the inclination of the pelvic brim, the part which is posterior is always at a lower level than the anterior part. The manoeuvre starts after the delivery of body up to the level of scapulae. When inferior angle of scapulae are visible, baby is held at the pelvis with two thumbs parallel to the spine. Along with traction, the baby is rotated through 180 degree so that posterior shoulder becomes anterior and slips under the symphysis pubis. Then the shoulder which has become posterior is rotated forward so that it also gets delivered. Care should be taken to maintain back anteriorly, otherwise occipito-posterior position will result.
How will you deliver occipito-posterior head in breech?
By Prague's manoeuvre. An assistant gives suprapubic pressure to maintain flexion. First, the traction is given horizontally and not downwards because downward traction causes extension of head in occipito-posterior position. When chin slips under symphysis pubis, baby is flexed over the mother's abdomen so that head delivers by flexion.
How do you deliver nuchal arms?
The nuchal arm, that is posteriorly displaced arm, is a complication of iatrogenic manipulations, so one must take precaution to prevent it. If the arm slips behind the body of the baby is rotated towards the hand so that the nuchal arm automatically comes anteriorly.
What are the dangers involved in breech delivery?
It is the baby who suffers most in the breech delivery. Breech presentation is associated with very high intrapartum and postnatal mortality because of prematurity, fetal anomalies and asphyxia.
Why is fetal asphyxia more common in breech delivery?
Due to placental abruption, head entrapment, cord compression, aspiration and intracranial hemorrhage due to sudden compression and decompression of aftercoming head of the fetus. The problems faced are minor degrees of disproportion cannot be detected until the head comes down, there is no time for molding of the head and chances of cord prolapse and chances of cord compression between fetal head and maternal pelvis are more.
Which fetal injuries are common in breech delivery?
Various injuries may occur in breech labor due to manipulations and maneuvers that are carried out. Groin traction can cause dislocation of hip during delivery of trunk, fracture of pelvis or injury to the abdominal viscera may occur. During delivery of hands, fracture of clavicle and humerus can occur. Traction to the neck may result in fracture dislocation of cervical spine and stretching of cervical nerve plexus may lead to earth palsy or compress paralysis.
Right. In spite of all these problems, in the hands of an expert obstetrician and in well-selected cases, the outcome of vaginal breech delivery should be excellent. Particular care has to be taken to assess the pelvis correctly, as minor degrees of pelvic contractions may allow the body of the baby to pass down but obstruct the aftercoming head, a situation which will invariably result in fetal loss and must be avoided by careful judgment. This is the end of the 7th clinic in obstetrics on pregnancy with bleeding.